Assalamu alaikum students, your instructor Abdul Rafi here. So this is lecture number 2 on the topical past papers of the sequences for IGCSE Mathematics 0580. We are doing currently topical past papers of 2021 and doing all types of sequences question. We already have an idea now for the linear and the quadratic sequences, but now it's time to increase our level and go on to more types of sequences to understand. Most of the time, students, the paper pattern tells us, and last couple of years we can see they mostly test on linear and quadratic and geometric as well. But in some recent past papers, we have seen that they are testing on cubic sequences as well a lot. So first thing is, how do you judge when it's a cubic sequence? And secondly, what are the formulas? I have already written the formulas that you must memorize in order to get the correct answers. Okay, so we'll talk about them, but let's first understand. So this is again 2021 October-November paper 2 variant 1. All of the questions that I'm discussing are 2021 topical past papers. So let's start. We have to find the end term, as this is a common question. Again, these are all paper 2 questions. You will be getting paper 4 videos as well soon. So we have 8, 15, 34, 71 and 132. Okay, so students need to understand that it will be 8. Try to find out what is the ratio there. So if 8 plus 7 is 15, right? So 8 plus 7 is 15. Okay, so 8 plus 7 is 15, and then 15 add how much to get 34. So it will be plus 19, 15 plus 19 to get 34, and then 71 minus 34, I got 37. You add 37 in this to get basically 71, and 71 plus something to get basically 132. So 61 you have to add for this one. Okay, students, so this clearly says, when you find out the first difference, students, it clearly will tell you, that's how you go, that this is not a linear. Okay, this is not a linear one. So sir, maybe it's a quadratic. Okay, so let's find the second constant difference. Second difference, so when we talk about 7 and 19, so I think 7 plus 12 should give us 19. Okay, so we can say that, sir, 7 plus 12 and then 19, 37 and 19, it's the 18. Okay, so plus 18 is coming here. Second difference is coming. 19 plus 18 will give me 37, and this one should be 24. 37 plus 24. So this also will imply that this is not a quadratic sequence, students, because we have discussed in detail that in a quadratic sequence, the second difference will be coming constant. Okay, the second difference should come constant in a quadratic sequence, and it is not coming here. Okay, students. And for a linear sequence, the first difference should be constant. Okay, so what we need to do, we need to move further on, and we'll find out that this will be called a cubic sequence, and the reason is because the third difference is going to come constant. Okay, students, so it will be 12 plus 6 is 18, and 18 plus 6 is 24, students. So here we go, sir, that the third difference is coming constant, which will lead to the idea, students, that this is going to be the cubic sequence. And how do you find out the cubic sequence term? We are going to work it out. Okay, so hope students are getting it, that after the linear, quadratic, if they are not linear, quadratic, it will be definitely a cubic sequence. Okay, so let's work it out, because we have now got an idea that it's a cubic sequence, because the space is less here, because there's a past paper question. So let me just solve it on the other page. Okay. Okay, so here we go. We are going to say that the formula will be here, an cube plus bn square plus cn plus d. This is going to be called a cubic sequence. Okay, because a quadratic one was, this one was called a quadratic one sequence, right, students? This one is called a quadratic one. So the other one, the first one, is called the cubic sequence. Okay, so this is the term for the cubic sequence, and this one is for the quadratic sequence, right? So we'll have to find out the values of a, b, c and d here. Okay, to get the answer, we'll have to find out the values of a, b, c and D values, okay? So let's start working on this, students. As you know, these are the four formulas that we'll have to take into account. So we'll start always with the simple one, which will give our first value. And the first simple one is the 6a is equals to the third difference, that is the constant difference, okay? So you are going to say that, sir, this is going to be 6 times of a is equals to 6, where a value will come out as 1, okay? So hope students got this. Very important, a value is going to come out as 1, students. The reason is simple there, because 6a is equals to the third term difference, right? And the third term difference is 6 and 6 here as well, okay? So that's how we got it, okay? Then the next one will be, because we got the value of a here, so we can apply to this one, okay? That is 12a plus 2b is going to be our second difference, okay? 12a plus 2b is equals to be our second difference. So what is our second difference, students? Follow carefully. Our second difference is going to be the 12, okay? The first second difference will be 12, okay? So you are going to say that 12a plus 2b is equals to 12, okay? So here we go, students. 12a plus 2b is equals to second difference, and second difference is this one, so it will be 12. And here we go, it will be a value you put in, a value is 1. 12 plus 2b is equals to 12, so 2b is equals to 0, 12 minus 12. So in fact, b value is 100% going to be 0, students, okay? So hope students are getting it, that the b value is 0 and a value is 1. So we have already got two values, two more values to go, okay? So b value is 0 and a value is 1, okay, students? Hope students are getting this and clear. The third formula says that we have to do 7a plus 3b plus c, that is will give us the first difference, okay? This will give us the first difference, 7a plus 3b plus c. And what is the first difference, students? The first difference is plus 7, or let's make it a different highlighter. First difference is the 7. So here we go, sir, you are going to write it here that 7a plus 3b plus c is the first difference, that is going to be 7, okay? So here we go, 7 ones are 7, 3 times of 0, c value is going to come as also 0, students. 7 ones are 7 plus 0 plus c is equals to 7, so c is also going to be 0, students. So c value is also coming as 0, okay? So a value is 1, b value is 0, sir, and c value is also 0, sir, okay? And the last value will be the d value, that is the single constant term, okay? So let's work it out. The d value, which you can find easily by a plus b plus c plus d, which is equivalent to the first term, that is going to be 8, okay, students? It is going to be equals to 8. So here we go, write it down. A plus b plus c plus d is equals to the first term, that is 8, okay? And here we go, a is 1, b is 0, c is 0, d we don't know, it is 8, so d value will be 8 minus 1, that is 7. So here we go, students, that's the answer. D is equivalent to 7. Hope students get this, that d value is going to come as 7. And now your cubic sequence value is confirmed, that is n cubed plus 7 is the answer, because b and c both are 0, students. So we got n cubed plus 7 as our answer. That's how you have to find out the cubic sequence. Make sure you will have to memorize the formula, remember them. You will start with the smallest one, that is which one will give you one constant one. So you write down the answer here, and as I always mention, just try to check with one value to see whether the answer is coming correct or not. So we have n cubed plus 7 as the answer, and let me check as well whether it's coming correct or not. So here we go, the fifth term. Let's say first term, this is first term, second term, third term, fourth term, and fifth term, okay? So we need to understand the fifth term is coming 132, right? So here we go. Let's see fifth term. So n cubed plus 7. So if I do 5 cubed plus 7, so it will be 125 plus 7. And this is going to give us the final answer. 125 plus 7 is 132, and that is matching, which means our answer is 100% correct, students, okay? So hope everyone gets this, everyone is clear. How do you find the cubic sequences, students? The first thing is, how do you judge? First, you will check, let me summarize for you. If it's not a linear, then you check for quadratic. If it's not even a quadratic, then you check for other sequences, and one of them is cubic sequences, where you'll have to find four terms A, B, C, and D, okay? It's coming very less, but in the recent papers, I'm expecting in the current paper, they can definitely test you. So make sure follow this working. You can copy, take screenshot, and understand how do you get this working, okay? So it's basically the third difference that is going to come constant. Just like in the quadratic students, the second term comes constant. In the cubic, it will be the third term coming constant, and that's how you will figure out it's a cubic sequence and work out starting with this formula, that is 6a is equals to the third difference, and then going to the top tier. Okay, so hope everyone gets this. Follow for more content. Thank you.